Yeah.
But yeah, I have to say I'm a complete fan. I think like you are probably my favorite commentator ever.
Well, wow. Thank you very much. Yeah, thank you very much. I mean, I try to do it from my heart because, okay, I just love chess so much. And I also know how much effort the top players are putting into in order to be in such shape that they are in order to compete for the top. So all my respect for them. And I'm also trying to be kind of like a bridge to give it to the audience so that they can imagine how it feels like, what it takes to be playing on this tournament.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's all your chess stories, your chess knowledge. And like you said, like your honesty while you're doing it. I am, I'm a fan.
Yeah, thank you, Tanya. And by talking about heritage, it comes to my mind because suddenly I thought, okay, what is this heritage? What I have? I have experienced so much. But one of these heritage moments that comes for me in my mind is, now during you talked about, when I just started playing chess, it was 87. It was the Interzonal tournament in Subotica. I was still a complete amateur and Mikhail Tal was playing in this tournament and I wanted to get his autograph, but we couldn't park at the venue and we came a little bit late. And when I tried to run to the stage, the games just started and the arbiter stopped me. The 7-year-old boy got stopped by the arbiter to try to collect the autograph. And Mikhail Tal from the side, he saw me. And he saw that I was so desperate and the arbiter stopped me. And instead of making his move, he stood up, came down and signed me. And, you know, I feel like it influenced my whole chess career and my whole life of thinking, you know, this moment was so, so dramatic what Mikhail Tal did for me.
Wow.
Yeah. And I carry this with me all my life.
That's it. Can we give all the prizes to Peter, please?
No, I don't need any prizes. I'm happy if you guys... anyone wins anything, but I just wanted to share this because I even did it was not planned to share this, but I even forgot about it during commentary. But when you guys talked about this, then it came back and I had to share it.
You know, your chess heritage story reminds me of my chess heritage story. So I was, I'm from Delhi and a very little chess culture from where I started, there was really none at all. And in my school, I was studying a lot and I only started playing professionally once I got out of school. So it was my younger, I was around 10 or 11 years old and I had a lot of sort of pressure from school and sort of that, you know, doing other things and not being involved with chess so much. So it was kind of, but I loved playing. So it was sort of hard to decide what I wanted to do. And then there was a simul with Vishy that was there. And I remember I was chosen as one of the young kids from Delhi to be part of that and to play against Vishy. And he was playing 25 kids. He of course beat me really quickly, and then there was this thousands of people who wanted to get his autograph and a photo with him, and I was standing there and he was, you know, going to leave soon, but he saw me standing there and he actually like agreed to have a photo with me and give me his autograph. And he was such a legend, and I think that was a very impactful moment for me as well, when I decided that all the school stuff really doesn't matter and chess is where my heart is. Is anyone crying?
Your stories are so heartwarming. I just was very unathletic, so I didn't have a choice.